Good morning, dear students. Welcome back again for our first lesson of biology, that is fundamental unit of life. In yesterday's session, we have seen the basic things related to the cell, the definition of cell, and the components in which the cell is made up of. Okay. So yesterday's session, I have told you, cell is the fundamental unit of life. Fundamental means very important, okay? And the another meaning of the cell or the definition of the cell is the structural and functional unit of all living organism is called as a cell, okay? Or the whole body of an organism, it may be plant or it may be animal. The smallest unit of all the living organism is cell, okay? So how the cell is discovered? Which scientists are involved into the discovery of the cell, that we will talk. There were various scientists who had worked on it, but the credit goes to the first scientist. The name of that scientist is Robert Hooke, and his era was 1635, means 1635 to 1703. During this period, he has suggested or he has discovered the cell. Okay, so in your book it is given 1665, but how it comes, that I shall explain you. So what Robert Hooke has done first, Robert Hooke has taken one cork cell. What is meant by students cork cell? Cork cell is obtained from the bark of the tree. It is obtained from the bark of the tree. Students, we are knowing when we go outside, we can see the barks of the tree. On the stem part, there is a bark of the tree, okay, which we can remove also easily. Why we can remove, students, that bark of the tree easily? Because that bark of the tree is dead cells. Here, dead cells are present. And later on, this Robert Hooke also come to know that we have seen the cells which are of dead cell. So bark of the tree contains dead cell, and those cells are, or those tissues are called as a sclerin chymatous cell or sclerin chymatous tissue. Whenever we will learn about tissue, that time you will get to know what is meant by sclerin chymatous tissues. So here what he has done, he has taken one cork cell. What he did, he took a thin slice of a cork cell and he tried to observe that cork cell under his self-made microscope. He had one microscope which under which he could observe various things. Okay, surround us, he could observe that. He has used that microscope for his discovery to observe various things. Or this is also called as a primitive microscope, which was really very simple microscope. So what he did, he took one cork cell, that this cork cell is obtained from the bark of the tree, and what he did, he tried to observe the thin slice of the bark cell under the his primitive microscope or his self-made microscope, which was not not much definitions, right? Primitive microscope, he observed that cork cell under the microscope. And when he observed, he found the structure like a honeycomb. Students, you are knowing the structure of the honeycomb. Here, honeys are storing their honey or nectar, right? The structure he observed like that under the microscope. Like that structure he could observe, and that structure was resembling like a honeycomb. Students, are you aware about honeycomb? Honeycomb means honey are keeping their nectar into this comb, and later on it is converted into honey. Nectar is very thin substance, okay, which is getting, which they are acquiring from the flower, okay, and that nectar then converted into thicker honey. But for temporarily, they are keeping that honey into the honeycomb, okay, and they are using it as a food also, okay. So the cell were looking like a honeycomb. He observed it, and they were in a tiny box. They were tiny box, means nothing he could find in that. And so that he said, for that thing was there. It was looking like a tiny box. And later on he come to know those cells were dead cells of the bark tree. Bark of the tree. Those cells were dead cells. Okay. He had done the thing. Later on, whatever he had discovered, he published that all discovery in his book in 1665. He published one book in 1665. The name of the book was Micrographia. The name of that book was Micrographia. And in that book, Micrographia, he explained explained his discovery in that book. Actually, he could see only the empty boxes under the microscope. But his discovery actually is worth a lot. Because of his discovery, we come to know that the smallest unit of all living cell, of all living thing is a cell. So his discovery matters a lot. I hope you understand this concept. The first scientist who has discovered the cell under his primitive microscope during the era 1635 to 1703, that is Robert Hooke. He took a thin slice of a cork. He observed it under the microscope. He could find a structure like a honeycomb, which was a tiny box which were empty. Nothing was there because that was a dead cell. He could not find any other material in it. Then in 1665, he published one book. The name was Micrographia. And in that book, he explained whatever he had done. And his discovery of the cell was a lot. After the cell discovery of Robert Hooke in 1665, whatever he did for the cell, means to discover the cell, later on one more scientist was there who did a lot for the discovery of the cell. And the name of that scientist, he was the Dutch scientist. The name of it is Anton van Leeuwenhoek, and the era is from 1632 to 1723.
Animal cell
free living animal cell which was into the pond water, and that is called animalcules. And then in 1678 he observed the sperm cell of the human being and all these animals, and he was the first scientist to observe the red blood cells, bacteria and the protozoa. So this work was done by Anton von Leeuwenhoek. After the Anton von Leeuwenhoek, later on one more scientist was there. The name of that scientist was Robert Brown, which was the Scottish botanist. It was the Scottish botanist. Scottish botanist. Students, what is meant by botanist? Botany is the branch of biology which deals with the study of only plants. Okay, and he was the Scottish botanist. In the year of 1831. In the year of 1831, what he did, he first tried to find out the nucleus which is present into the nucleus. The nucleus which is present into the cell. He was the first scientist to observe under the microscope nucleus into the cell. So, credit of the cell discovery goes for the Robert Brown too. Later on, one more scientist was there who had also done a great job. And the name of that scientist is J.E. Perkin Jay. J.E. Perkin Jay. Perkin Jay. In the year of 1839, what he did? He tried to observe today's so-called cytoplasm. Nucleus was discovered by Robert Brown. Later on, he tried to discover. This is the nucleus at the middle. And beside it, the cytoplasm is present. But in those days, this cytoplasm was called as a protoplasm. And this protoplasm was first seen under the microscope. It was observed by the J.E. Perkin Jay in 1839. So, I hope students you understand the discovery of the cell done by the various scientists. The first scientist was Robert Hooke, then second is Anton von Leeuwenhoek, third is Robert Brown, and fourth is J. Perkin Jay. So this is all about the cell discovery. In tomorrow's lecture, I will be talking about cell theory. That cell theory is also important. Thank you so much.